worried about or look at the pictures, watch the video. Incredible. Even after all the times you've visited different ones, there's nothing like being in an actual void, a new one, for the first time. Incredible, incredible. Just look. Have you ever seen a void like this in your entire existence? Or throughout your different lives? It, like I just said, I don't want to brag. I'm not the multiverse's leading expert on voids. I've seen my share. I do like this sound. You have to pardon me. Anyway. Expert when it comes to voids, but being as it's my passion for painting voids in particular, well, I've seen my fair share, but this void charts. I mean, sorry. Let's see, what void is this? I'm a little bit of a nerd when it comes to voids. Not only do I like to paint them, I do like to write, keep some notes, interesting reminders and anecdotes about them for my personal leisure when I'm just out traversing the multiverse. I just like to, you know, fond memories and such. is the 93rd void of the 36th quadrant of the 82nd parallel, located in the 21st dimension of the 78th universe, in the second multiverse, past Linda's laundromat. Yeah. Also known as Zach the Void. So, yeah. I'm speaking like this because I don't mean to bore you. Surface. Okay, just like me. Okay, so let me load up my very expensive premium painting palette. It's made out of ivory, if you believe that. You don't believe that? It's okay. I try. It's some cheap polymer plastic from a planet known as Plurth. Verth. Something like that. So, we'll put Mars black in the three spaces here. And then we'll put the ivory black. In the remaining spaces. Okay. Might have to come back and refill the paints. Okay, now for the brushes. I have a very thin detail brush. You can see that one. A lot of, believe it or not, to the untrained eye, all voids, and this is a terrible thing to say. I hope it's not listening. All voids look the same. I know, I shouldn't really say that. But once you begin to encounter them more frequently, you begin to make out all the little details about them that make each void unique. So, that's what this little detail brush is for. Then we have this fan brush, some nice broad feathery type of strokes and texture. And then two more flat brushes of a one, this one, the wider one I'll be using, to more broad strokes, less detail. And I'll be using this one as well. Some more shadow, things like that, layers, etc. But start with this brush. Start with this brush to apply the base coat, and we'll go with the asking, how did you end up here? Oh, really? You used Zogthrip's multiverse travel agency, too? Wow. What are the chances of that, huh? Like they say, it's a small multiverse. And how about that Flarmok? Such a great travel agent. Okay, let's just... So far. And you can see, I'm already going through that first portion of paint. I must admit, I'm not really used painting in front of strangers. Although, you look vaguely familiar. So this is going to be the base coat. Like I said, this is the base coat, and this will give be the foundation on which we will then begin to paint the void. passing, space-faring vessels. So is this your first time, in a void? You know, I'll never forget the first time I met a void. It was a long time ago when I was young, about, 10 years old. That's good enough for the base coat. But as I was saying, that young void that was a transfer student, we became good friends. I also forgot to mention my little painting knife. Thank you. painter. I think they might have retired. It's been a millennia or so since I last spoken with them, but yeah, you might have heard about them. So what do you think so far? Might not be my best work. Like I said, you being here and it's okay. It's making me a little self-conscious, I must admit. But while we're just getting started, you look a little drowsy, sleepy. I can't tell. The lighting in here isn't the greatest, but well, if you happen to fall asleep or take a nap, that's okay. I'll be here for the next. Well, painting a void like this, it usually takes me a few months, so you don't have to stay for the entire time if you don't want. Let's put the knife aside for a moment. Let's get some of those details using our little detail brush. Some of that Mars black, just load it up right there. Don't be shy in case you're painting along, painting this void with me. Try to capture the details as best we can. Do you see all those details? Now that you've been here for a little bit of time, you can start to see the details of the void pop right out. So, thank you. just it. I'll do that after this. Let's get some more of that shading. Do you see the details and the different textures and the shades? How they play with each other? Let's try to capture that. essence of this particular void. But we still have many days and weeks and months ahead of me, ahead of us. Let's get some of that Mars. Okay, and then we'll grab some of that ivory. And we'll mix the two together. And we'll get Marsbury. Again. See that? Thank you. I know I've been focusing on this area primarily, and I'll get to the lower area probably months from now, but this is where I primarily want to focus, because this is where the eye is going to go, and this right here is really what tells you about the void. I mean, this angle. So this might not be my best work, but I usually don't paint in front of anyone else. I think it's coming along. What do you think? Think it's all right so far? Are you even awake? Hard for me to Regardless, I have a lot of work still ahead of me. Well, it was a pleasure having you join me and having you for company. Who knows, maybe we'll see each other again sometime in the future. Who knows where our paths may lead and if they will ever cross again. So, if you can hear me or not, you take care, safe travels, and be seeing you around. Let's get some more than